In the last video, we talked about how to find the eigenvalues of a matrix. You find the characteristic polynomials, you find the roots of that characteristic polynomial, and boom, you've got the eigenvalues. But what about the eigenvectors? So, the object of the game here is, first of all, remember the definition of the eigenspace. The eigenspace is a set of all solutions to Ax equals lambda x. And this is almost the same thing as the set of all eigenvectors with eigenvalue lambda. The one exception is a zero is in the eigenspace and eigenvectors is supposed to be non-zero. But aside from that one exception, this is basically the set of all eigenvectors with that particular eigenvalue. And so we need to figure out what this eigenspace looks like. And I claim that an eigenspace is actually a null space. It's a null space of the matrix A minus lambda times the identity, or if you prefer, it's a null space of lambda times the identity minus A. This matrix and this matrix have the exact same null space because they're just negatives of each other. Solving this times x equals 0 is the same thing as solving this times x equals 0. Some people prefer to work with A minus lambda times the identity. Some people prefer to work with lambda times the identity minus A. You get the same answers either way. So to find a basis for E lambda, well, you have to find a basis for a null space. And how do you find a basis for a null space? You row reduce. So you have to take A minus lambda times the identity, or lambda times the identity minus A if you prefer, and you row reduce it, and then you find all of the solutions to A minus lambda times the identity x equals 0. And the claim is that that's the same thing as the eigenspace. So let's see why. Suppose we have something that's in the eigenspace. That means that Ax equals lambda x. And of course, lambda x is the same thing as lambda times the identity matrix times x. But that means that A minus lambda times the identity times x equals 0. Or if you prefer, you can say lambda times the identity minus Ax equals 0. And by definition, that means that x is in the null space of A minus lambda times the identity, or it's negative. Okay, so there you have it. Let's work an example. Work our favorite example, which is the matrix 2, 1, 1, 2. Now, in the last video, we computed the characteristic polynomial of this matrix and discovered it was lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 3. And then we found the roots of that characteristic polynomial, and they were 1 and 3. And so now that tells us the eigenvalues of A are 1 and 3, and we need to figure out what the eigenvectors are. And we do it one eigenvalue at a time. You can't do the whole thing at once. Each different eigenvalue requires a separate calculation. So we start with lambda equals 1. When lambda equals 1, A minus lambda times the identity is just, well, that's A, and that's 1 times the identity. You subtract it off and you get this 2 by 2 matrix. And you see, this is a singular matrix. When you row reduce it, you get something with only one pivot. Well, now we solve this times x equals 0. We only have one equation, and that equation is x1 plus x2 equals 0. And we rewrite that as an equation for the pivot variable in terms of the free variable. And then we pad it with a x2 equals x2, and put these two things together, and it says the whole vector x, x1, x2, is a certain constant, namely x2, times negative 1, 1. So the basis for this eigenspace is just the single vector negative 1, 1. Now, we could have used twice that vector, or three times that vector, or minus that vector. Sometimes it's more convenient to work with 1 minus 1 instead of negative 1, 1. But it's the same direction. It's the axis that's running northwest to southeast. That's one eigenvalue. We still have to look at the other eigenvalue. When lambda is 3, A minus 3 times the identity is A minus 3 times the identity. And that gives us negative 1, 1, 1. So this is the matrix that we have to row reduce. And it row reduces to 1, negative 1, 0, 0. Then we write down our equations. There is only one equation, x1 minus x2 is 0. So x1 is x2. Of course, x2 equals itself. And that means the vector x has to be some multiple of 1, 1. So our basis for the eigenspace E3 is 1, 1. So a picture of the two eigenspaces looks like this. In the 1, 1 direction is the eigenspace E3. In the 1, minus 1 direction is the eigenspace E1. And all other directions give you vectors that aren't eigenvectors. So that's the full story for matrices. But what if we wanted to find the eigenvalues of a linear operator? If you had a linear operator, well, you always try to make things look like matrices by picking a basis. Now, I'm not talking about a basis of eigenvectors. I'm just talking about any old basis for the vector space V. So you pick a basis, and we know that if L of x is a multiple of x, you just take the coordinates of both sides, and you get that the matrix of L times the coordinates of x equals lambda times the coordinates of x. And that means that the coordinates of x is an eigenvector of the matrix of L with eigenvalue lambda. In other words, the eigenvalues of L are exactly the eigenvalues of the matrix of L. So the object of the game is you pick a basis, and it doesn't even matter which basis you use. Different bases will give you different matrices, but those matrices will all have the same eigenvalues. And we'll call the characteristic polynomial of L, we'll define that to be just the characteristic polynomial of this matrix. And no matter what basis you use, you get the same characteristic polynomial. So that's how you find the eigenvalues of L. You find the eigenvalues of this matrix. And how do you find the eigenvectors? You find the eigenvectors of this matrix. And those are the coordinates of the eigenvectors of L.